Here. Pin number. Don't lose it.
I thought you were Smithy.
Smithy's gone. They found a man buried alive halfway down the bluff. Coyotes got at him. They really dug into him. No ID. He was castrated.
I guess I'm gonna have to take care of everything around here now.
Roth tried to get to Smithy, but he took off.
You know, there's a path along the side of the house. Goes right down to the ravine trails, along the edge of the bluffs, where sometimes people fall and die. Just like that man. You could take that path right now.
Roth has reopened the case.
My uncle and my mother are not missing.
It's been reopened for Hunter Husk. Smithy told me a lot of shit. Shit that could hurt people. Roth's gonna come around and start asking me questions too.
Why stick around?
I'm not Luca. I'm not your mom. I can't disappear.
There's Peggy's garage light, still on, pointing right at my face. There's gotta be some sort of bylaw against that, right?
It's like someone staring right at your face, isn't it?
Staring at me? It's a garage light.
Mrs. Blair told me she saw a guy in a black SUV. Who was that?
You talked to Blair? Batty Blair next door? Did she tell you how handsome Luca is?
Mrs. Blair said she had no idea Luca had a sister. Blair was surprised when your mom showed up last summer in her new Prius.
It wasn't new. It was used. Luca used to say that buying a used car
is the best worst decision of your life. Smithy said your mom was kind of kinky. Something about the way she'd look at him.
Not sure that describes my mother. Bet Brenna.
She'd drive up in her little white Prius and say she'd want to go for a walk in the ravine. I don't know. He said it was like some kind of invitation.
To what?
To follow her.
Where?
Into the ravine.
Thank you.
My mother always imagined that people, men, were following her.
What if Roth does find Smithy? And he starts talking about Luca, your mom, and you. That's why our stories have to match. So they know we're telling the truth. Okay? Why did Luca hire Smithy?
To mow the lawn, put the garbage out.
And let him have his credit card?
To take care of the place.
How is it you've never met him?
He only comes when I'm out, at work.
You've been here for 2 years.
Maybe Luca told him to keep his distance. Maybe Luca told him I'm dangerous.
Smithy said Bette checked in on Luca all the time.
So?
She said she forgot her key.
Smithy let her in. So?
Smithy said your mom was a shitty liar. Almost embarrassing.
It can be hard to tell a good lie. You have to be a
psychopath.
Or someone like Bette Brenna.
Or someone like you. Last summer, your mother got a letter from Luca that was just cut out letters from magazines.
Here we go again.
It said, "Bet I need you."
What if I told you that's impossible? What if I told you they haven't spoken to each other in years?
Last summer, your mom showed up here twice. On the first day, she pretended to be a regular visitor here.
And Smithy let her in.
And then the next day, she took a walk in Ravine. Then she goes to the police to make a statement. And instead of going home, she comes here. Spends the night.
And then Doucette comes, they talk, blah, blah, blah.
Then Bette disappears. And you never saw her?
I had gone back to my rented room. The apartment I share with Janet.
You think you'd know that your mom was coming here?
Maybe I did. Is Smithy a nice-looking guy?
It's like you knew something terrible was going to happen. Why didn't Smithy straight up tell your mom that Luke had already been away for a year in Mexico at that point? Why did Smithy let her pretend that she and Luca saw each other all the time? Why pretend they were friends? And that she regularly came to pick up Luca's mail?
Bette Brenna inspires loyalty. People believe her.
Maybe no one really knows how to question her.
Maybe they're afraid to question her. I'm glad she wasn't alone when she came back to the cul-de-sac.
Luca never said he had a sister. So, do you cut the lawns for everyone in the cul-de-sac?
Then Blair came over that day.
She brought shortbread from Peggy.
I guess all the neighbors know. When you see Peggy, you should let her know that her garage light is always on. I've been noticing. You know, I can drive you to the station if you want.
No.
I have my own car. I just bought it. Pre-loved. Luca used to always say that used cars. So, does Smithy take care of all the lawns here in the cul-de-sac?
You know, I've tried to get him into our little theater. He just has something. You live on the beaches, right? So after you've made your statement, you should just go home and try to forget. I think making your statement will be a good thing for you. Someone said that in order to forget something, you first have to remember it in order to forget it. I don't remember who said that.
Blair had a, I don't know, kind of like a premonition.
Of what?
That something bad was going to happen. Okay, so Blair wanted to take your mom to the station.
Because the police asked her to give a statement.
But she had a new car. She could drive herself. And why give a statement? Monique did not commit a crime.
They had to make sure she got her story straight. Maybe they wanted to make sure she told the story the way they wanted her to.
Why would someone like your mom even buy a car?
To get out of the apartment?
Leave her piano, you know, all the quiet. The next day, Detective Doucette came.
Mrs. Blair said she was pretty.
So have you ever walked along the bluffs?
To be honest, no. I'm not very good with heights, so no. So, but you don't actually live here, isn't that correct?
Did I give you my contact information last night?
Why exactly are you here?
Oh, I'm just here to pick up the mail for my brother, Luca.
Can you imagine being afraid of heights and then being assigned to a case that takes place along a ravine path at the edge of a bluff? How far down would you say?
Far enough.
She had a car accident right after talking to my mom.
Do you really think that's why Doucette came? To check up on Bette?
She wanted to hear the story. Again. Everyone wants to hear it.
That there was something funny in your statement that you made. In the contact information, you put that Luca Brenna was your bother.
I'm so embarrassed.
No, don't worry. I changed it. I understand it was really late.
It was. Thank you, Detective. Detective, what can I do for you?
Monique Blackthorne's self-harm has devastated the entire community, and she's fighting for her life right now. Following up is just good policing and shows our respect for the victim.
I just wonder if anyone ever told her that she was special and loved and wanted.
Don't you think it's weird that after Doucette came, your mom disappeared?
Where are we going with this?
If they hadn't have found that guy on the bluff, they hadn't reopened Hunter Huff.
Luca and my mom are not missing.
They still would have come for you.
There is nothing suspicious.
Sooner or later.
And you've been here in this house this entire time, even though you supposedly have an apartment?
What's weird about that?